doing in Dublin City Centre?
I call on Deputy Queen O'Quillan. Could we have order, please? Now, Deputy O'Quillan has the floor.
Gorda Mahigat, Las Can Corya. Tánaiste, I want to raise a matter with you that the purpose in doing so is to ask your support and intervention. It's in relation to the finance bill and a matter that has been brought to my attention subsequent to its passage through this chamber. It's currently before the Shannon, and I've spoken to colleagues and my colleague constituency, Senator Catherine Riley, will reflect it in today's contribution at second stage, and we will certainly seek to amend a matter that is of some considerable concern but has missed our collective attentions here in its passage so far. And I speak in relation to Section 74 and the Capital Acquisitions Tax. And I want to record just very clearly that we too support absolutely the principle of encouraging and supporting active farming, active farmers. I want to make that absolutely clear. But the provision in the finance bill under capital acquisitions tax would mean that from the 1st of January, a very short period of some just more than 3 weeks away, we're going to see a situation where on the demise of the parent or parents who are the active holders of any particular holding, or indeed if it were to be gifted, that on that acquisition, that the inheritor would have to be in a position to subsequently continue in active farming for a period of 6 years, or to lease the holding for a period not less than 6 years. Now, all of that is absolutely sound, but the area that has been missed in our collective address so far is the impact in relation to members of the diaspora. And I'm speaking from first-hand engagement with families in my own constituency that is made up of small to medium holdings. They're not the rancher class by any means. And there is a real concern that the displaced and intended inheritor who would absolutely be taking over the operation of the farming enterprise finds themselves, because there was no other supportive work to be involved in, finds themselves in the United States, in Australia, New Zealand, whatever is the case. Now, the requirement is that 50% of time is spent actively working on the farm. Now, that 50% of off-farm work has not been available for countless thousands of young traditional farming background people over past decade in particular. And the provision in the bill would mean that because of the circumstances in which they currently find themselves, many will not be able to take up immediate continuation of active farming. And if they were to opt for the lease, I'll just conclude with this point, for the lease approach, the bill actually says for a period not less than 6 years. Yet it had always been, certainly in the cases of which I reflect, their intention to return in a couple of years' time. Now, there is no interchangeability between the lease requirement or the active participation in active farming. And because they are part of the displaced diaspora because of the economic circumstances in which we found ourselves, they have been left out of consideration.
Thank you,
and the consequences will be dire. We're looking at a 33% tax in relation to their respective inheritance in just a little over 3 weeks' time. I ask you, Tánaiste, to make an intervention with the Minister for Finance. We will submit amendments, but I do believe it would be a greater certainty if the government would be willing to give their support.
Thank you, Deputy.
Well, first of all, as you know, one of the points of focus in the finance bill was to provide for better arrangements in relation to the transfer of land to younger farmers and people who want to go into farming, and to make arrangements and better arrangements in relation to older farmers retiring and stepping down. So if you're suggesting that in fact there's been a difficulty identified in relation to the arrangements which the Minister for Finance is suggesting in the legislation, well, obviously the discussion in the Senate, first of all, will actually provide for an opportunity to tease out all of the issues. I have to say, I'm not totally familiar with the section of the bill that you're referencing, but there have been a number of questions raised in relation to a number of issues relating to transfers and indeed to inheritance in the context of the finance bill. So what I would suggest is that if a further briefing is required from revenue officials and officials in the Department of Finance on the operation of the clauses in the section of the bill, section 74, that that can be provided, because clearly you have questions around how the clause would operate in practice. But without a doubt, the intention of the legislation is to actually make provision for the easier transfer of land to young farmers. Now, the reason that time limits are put in relation to such transfers is that obviously receiving inheritances or passing inheritances or passing over businesses to next generations or to relatives and doing so with a substantial tax mitigation, as is happening, that the revenue do have to be satisfied that it is in relation to bona fide, genuine participation in farming. I take your point that you're suggesting that in the case of somebody who might be out of the country, say for 1 year or for 3 years, having emigrated in order to get employment and then wanting to come back and perhaps to succeed into a family farm or take over a farm holding, that they might not satisfy some of the tests. What I strongly suggest is that the matter might be taken up, firstly with the revenue to explore some of the cases that you have concern about, but secondly in the context of the discussion on the bill. And I'll also take up the matter with Minister Noonan.
Deputy Cuivín O'Connell, supplementary question.
Well, I'm thankful that you're willing to raise it with Minister Noonan. The critical point here, Minister, is that there is no difference in our collective intent of seeking to ensure that agricultural and productive land is in the hands of active farmers, and young active farmers, of course. But we have a situation that is very particular to the past decade, and it is more particularly the case across smaller holdings across rural Ireland, where there may not always be sons, there may be daughters involved, but certainly in the cases that I know of, we're talking about a male progeny who has been displaced because there was not other activity available for employment within the area to sustain that extra a pair of shoulders in terms of the small holdings concerned. They were forced to emigrate. That's a fact of life. Now, if we're looking at a sudden death and an inheritance as a consequence, it's not that immediately simple for somebody to immediately extract themselves from whatever set of circumstances they may be in terms of business activity, commercial activity, or employment, whatever the circumstance. And that applies to people that I know now at this point in time. And what I'm saying is, and I agree that there have to be time frames, and what we're suggesting is a further time frame here, that there would be a period of grace for people in the circumstances of which I describe. It could be 3 years. You know, this can be determined. I'm only suggesting that that would be considered. But it would be tragic that because of the economic reality we've been in, the fact that they've been forced into emigration that they would now be further penalised as a result of that and their inability to immediately relocate here at home.
Thank
and
you,
that's exactly, if I could just conclude, Laskan Corya, that's exactly what would happen as of the 1st of January if this bill went through as it is currently texted.
Thank you.
So I again ask for a time frame period of grace, and I ask also for an interchangeability between the 6 years of active farming and the 6 years of leasing, because it actually states who leases the agriculture property for not less than 6 years. They may already have had the intention, and now with the demise of their parent or parents, would want to come home in a much shorter period of time. But the way the bill is structured, it locks them in to that particular period, and that would be penal in the circumstances. Your support and the Minister's support would be appreciated.
Well, again, I just want to thank you for raising the issue, because it is a very important issue for families in rural Ireland, and indeed for children or others who are away at the moment, because it is our hope, and in fact we can see it at the moment, that a lot of people who did emigrate for a number of years are beginning to return home, and that's become quite marked. And you will probably know as well that a lot of the recruitment firms are really stepping up their recruitment over the Christmas period, because so many young people will be coming back, and hopefully a lot of them in fact will be able to either stay or make plans to come back for employment that's become available. I think, as I said, Deputy, that the critical issue here is to see if the legislation, which is meant and has been widely welcomed, by the way, by farming organisations, it's meant to facilitate transfers to young active farmers who want to get into and committed to farmers, to farming, from transfers from older people. If you could perhaps bring forward a couple of examples, I would suggest that we could get the Revenue Commissioners to have a look at the scenarios that you're concerned about, and then see if it's possible to have either regulations or administration that takes into account some of the cases that you're describing. Obviously, it's important that the finance bill passes before the end of the Oireachtas term, for the reason, as you know, that there are USC and tax reductions due to come in on the 1st of January, and we're very anxious to see people having the advantage of those. But you've raised an important issue. I'll raise it with Minister Noonan, but in all these things it would be helpful if you could maybe get two or three examples of the kind of scenario that you have in mind. And, you know, from what you've said, I'd be familiar myself with cases like that arising. But the purpose of this legislation, and always in tax law, you do have to be careful of the law of unintended consequences. But I'm sure Minister Noonan, the Minister for Finance, will be quite happy to have a look at it. But it would be helpful, as I said, if you could just set out the scenarios that you feel are
Thank
the
you,
most
Jim. Now, for the technical group, Deputy Mick Wallace.
Thank you, Lassan Corda. Tánaiste, it would appear that neither Shannon Airport Authority or the government seem to know or keep proper records on what US military aircraft landed Shannon. On four occasions of late,